moon allows us to be receptive to the light. The moon catches the darkness and the light and brings them together. And as such, we are children of the moon. We are creations of the moon. It is through the moon that we have a light in the darkness. It is through the moon that we have a consciousness in our lives. We had only the sun, we would be mechanism of our spirit without independence. It is the moon which gives us our freedom. It is the moon which makes us sensitive. The moon which protects us. Visualize a half moon. The half moon is like a chalice. Feel that this moon chalice is also within your body, within your pelvis, within your heart, within your head. It is only by realizing that we do not have the whole, but only part of it, that we can become curious and open up to seek the light. Open up to it. We will begin with the lower chalice, your pelvic area. Here we can feel the different phases of the body. Just as the moon is moving inexorably from phase to phase, so also the body goes from breath to breath, heartbeat to heartbeat, meal to meal, drink to drink, sleep to sleep. It is the moon which also helps us to harmonize these rhythms. That the dark spaces in between those set times, those set moments, open us up for impulses to come to our higher center. First, feel the healing quality of the moon as it radiates into your pelvis. Bringing you in harmony with yourself, the others around you. How many of the rhythms come together, sleeping together, eating together. And feel how nice it is to have this harmony, this concert of rhythm. Being together in the same phase of the moon, the same flow of the moon. How the bodies of all living things are united by the rhythm of the moon. Feel also how the power of these rhythms holds a magical force. As every cycle in itself is a ritual, allowing you to build up strength to a crescendo. At every step, at every heartbeat, at every breath, and get our light. And the light in you which you gather can become so strong that it cannot be quenched by the darkness, neither the darkness outside of you nor the darkness inside of you. This is the magical power of the moon. You never lose the light, no matter how dark it gets. Because always there is this rhythm, this flow connecting you to the flow of all living beings. Ready, with the moon chalice in your pelvis, move to the moon chalice of your heart. Feel that here there are all the different phases of emotion, hope and despair, love and hate, joy and sorrow, pain and bliss. Not as set and rigid as the lower rhythms, but already more fluid, more playful, but going around in circles and circles nonetheless. Each cycle, on the tops and the depths, you can touch your spirit. You can reach out and feel the divine which lies beyond the human normal range of sensations. It's the power of the moon. It's like the inexorable tides of the sea. Drives you up so you can reach beyond yourself into the heavens and into the abyss. Know also that although every wave can carry you beyond yourself, eventually every wave will pass, and you will also return from the abyss and from the heavens back to the realm of man. Do not fight against the tides of your life. do not strive to only be up, to never be down. Be like a surfer, gliding over the waves, using them to boost yourself to where you want to be, and to speed yourself past points where you don't want to be. The tide itself is eternal, as old as mankind. Your experience of the tide, this is your own. By feeling the power of the moon, you can get more traction and it speeds you up to the heavens. You can get more speed to rush you through the low. Feel how the tides of the moon wash away all the old detritus of emotion, of feelings, the things which happen to you. They're all just a ripple in the ocean of humanity. The ocean itself is controlled by the moon. Feel how your spirit is navigating on this ocean, powered by the moon. See also that these tides are unequal. The wave may be just one wave, but we're all on different points of the same wave. Some are still climbing, others are already descending. Some are floundering and flailing, others are surfing. Allow the moon to steady you in these perpetual motions, so that you remain clear and strong. Attention to go upwards, to put the chalice of the skull here. There's the clockwork of words, of thought, of time, of people. Seem a bewildering thing in this chalice, as the motion is even far quicker than the tides of the heart. But yet, you're merely intersecting tides. Everybody has their own cycle, their own rhythm. It is in the head that all the individual rhythms can meet. Where the story of the world becomes an individual story. And where the moon gives access to the knowledge of the world. The wisdom of your ancestors, the powers of the animals. Let the moon guide you to become both a light for the others who are floundering in this chaos. And to turn this chaos into a rocking, a swaying motion of consciousness, which is going up, gathering light, bringing it to you, and going up again, gathering the light and depositing it in you. So slowly but surely, by being in touch now and again with the collective consciousness, slowly your own consciousness will grow and stabilize itself, find its place and its role within the ocean of humanity, within the ocean of the world. Stiller the ocean in your head will become, till eventually all these contrary motions and chaos start canceling each other out. And there is only the sea, no longer the waves. The moon chalices are complete. We are ready to reflect the divine light with a minimum of disturbance. Allow the light to fall through you from the top. Feel the moonlight as a ray descending through your head, heart, belly and legs, connecting the heavens and the earth, because this is the essence of what the moon does. It makes things both worldly and divine. Same time. Stay in this state for as long as you would like. It's a state of calm, a state of healing, a state of balance. A state which is yours, because you're a child of the moon. Connects you to all your brothers and sisters who are also children of the moon. In all worlds at the same time, earthly and divine, touching the heavens, the abyss, touching yourself and those around you. The moon gives you the perfect balance, the perfect center for your consciousness. short life.